The importance of voting and utilizing your voice for what you believe in, that we cannot be silent anymore. And I think that this show is really representative of all those different walks of life and types of people.
If this was really like your real life, would you choose between your family or a mission to Mars?
Well, I would like to go to space, but I don't really want to go to Mars because it takes 3 years. So I would choose my family. But you know, I understand having a dream and having a drive. So I can. There's part of me that like really understands what Emma Green is up against.
Hi, I am Joe from Voice Online. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah,
looks like you're in Mission Control. Lucky you.
I know. I'm in actually one of your offices. So I was so pumped last night because I decided to watch the first few episodes of Away before my bedtime. And it was so exciting, nerve-wracking. I could not go to bed. That's my reaction. What was your reaction when you first learned about the story and the script?
Well, I felt very much like you. It was a page turner. I couldn't stop reading it. I loved the multiracial crew. I loved seeing that we were all on this journey together on this mission to Mars and all the obstacles and ups and downs and trials and tribulations that come with that. But I also loved that there was this gravitational pull to all of our family on Earth. You know, that it's a real love story and then shows that kind of common commonality to all of us, that we're all just human beings trying to figure it out.
That is so true. So how would you describe your character and the motivation behind her, behind this beautiful image, smart and brave woman who happens to be the commander of the LSF crew?
Yeah, I would say that she is a remarkable human being who also is just struggling to try and figure it out and to not let people down and is vulnerable and just doing the best that she can to be the best commander and the best mother and wife, and oftentimes feels like she's failing at everything.
Right.
And that's just, I think, such a human quality.
So there's an LGBTQ storyline. Story too. Can you tell me more about it?
Yeah, that's another thing that I love about this story is it's like it really deals with of all different types of love stories and all different kind of colors that represent the real world, you know. And for so long, these stories have been told through really a white male point of view that Lou, the character that you're speaking of, is in love with a woman named May. And that story is just so beautiful and so heartbreaking to see, you know, what happens to people with like just the pressure of society, really, you know, that we still have a long way to go.
That's true. So after watching only a few episodes of Away, I see diversity, sacrifices, and the trust that must be earned from the people around you in order to survive the very difficult like the world. What would be your key message to your audience, especially that we are living in such a critical time? Not been easy for the humankind this year.
Yeah, I would say this show is like paralleling a lot of things from like what it feels like to be in self-isolation and the need for hope, and also the importance of voting and utilizing your voice for what you believe in, that we cannot be silent anymore. And I think that this show is really representative of all those different walks of life and types of people.
Cool. So last question, if this was really like your real life, would you choose between your family or a mission to Mars?
Well, I would like to go to space, but I don't really want to go to Mars because it takes 3 years. So I would choose my family. But you know, I understand having a dream and having a drive. So I can, there's part of me that like really understands what Emma Green is up against.